Your very last fight, Usyk,
yeah.
Who's an absolute beast, who's probably
the best cruiserweight in my opinion.
Yeah, pound for pound. Yeah, so going up against that, how were you going all out then? This was your moment.
Very hard. No, do you know what? I got married. I saw Fort David in the May, May the 5th, and then in the rematch. And then I got married on July the 7th, same year. In my mind, I was retired. Eddie just said to me, listen, you've cracked it. You've swam the channel. You've made so much fucking money in these fights that you don't need to ever think about money again. And he was right. You know, we'd done well. I mean, by the way, I'm skint. I mean, my wife's loaded, but I'm fucking skint. Yeah. So I'd made a fortune. So I just said to him, okay, then, well, I suppose we'll call it a day. I got married in the July. Eddie's at my wedding. Probably one of the only people in the boxing world that's at my wedding. So, Eddie and Derek Chisora, James DeGale. So, as a lovely wedding, I goes on my honeymoon. I'm on my honeymoon, and some fella makes me look at the phone. He goes, you're watching this, the World WBSS finals on. I was like, mate, I've got a fucking big bottle of champagne in my hand. My fucking new wife's here. I'm drinking my fucking brain out. I'm having a fucking laugh. Fuck off. A couple of minutes went by, and I thought, too sick that I'll just go and have a little look. So I said to me, missus, enjoy that drink. And she was talking to someone. I said, I'll be back in a minute. Where are you going? I said, no way. You don't need to know. Don't worry about it. And I'm fucking, before I know, I'm watching this fucking fight on his phone like this. So before I know it, the people have been talking in the place, and the fella's got it on the screen. I'm watching on the screen this place, and I'm like, yeah. So it's a good fight. This Usyk's fucking brilliant. He just played with Gassiev from start to finish. Gassiev couldn't lay a glove on him, didn't do fuck all. Slow feet, can't beat him with them. So at the end of the fight, I thought, oh yeah, not an obby. And then I thought, it was a good fight, that's it. But I'm retired now. There's no need for me to fucking think about him. And I just did Tony Bellew. And I thought, cheeky cunt. I thought, you cheeky bastard. And then he said it again. I thought, my fucking eating things. Well, this is why you shouldn't go out and get pissed with your phone on you. So I goes in the toilet, my phone's Eddie in. It was about 1 o'clock in the morning in Mykonos, or 2 o'clock in the morning. I says, you get me that fucking cunt. I said, I'm gonna take his head off. Eddie in says, Tone, you don't need that fight. He said, you're financially secure, everything's sound. Why do you want to fight him? I said, he's just called me name out on the telly, Ed. I said, he's got all them belts. Imagine becoming undisputed cruiserweight champion. He said, you don't need it. I said, I'll tell you what. If you don't make the fight, I'll go on my social media now and make the fight. He said, all right, I'll sort it out. Don't worry about it. The fucking thoughts of Eddie losing a pound. He fucking soon got on the phone. So I don't remember anything else. I remember having that conversation. In all honesty, I don't remember having that conversation. That's a lie. I'm just telling you what Eddie's told me over the years. What I do remember is waking up on the Sunday morning and having the worst hangover ever, because I don't drink, as I said, drinking champagne with me fucking missus all night after on our honeymoon. It was mad. Eddie says to me, I thought, shit, what's he phoning for? Goes in the toilet, answers the phone, where she can't hear what we're talking about. If Eddie's calling, it's going to be something to do with boxing. So he goes, the fight's done. I'm like, what are you talking about? He went, the fight's done. He said, he's agreed to everything you want. You know, you're the man, it's on your terms, it's your bill, he'll take a flat fee, whatever. And I was Ed, what are you, he said, Usyk, you phoned me last night and told me to make the fight. I said, no, I fucking didn't. He said, yes, you fucking did. I said, oh my God. He said, it's all agreed. He said, are you messing around? So you don't want it? And I went, and once again, I said, yeah, fuck it, I'll do it. And he just went, sound.
How was that?
We came home from Mykonos. And because we'd been on our honeymoon, we only went on our honeymoon for 4 days, but Miss wouldn't leave the kids any longer. And we went straight to Portugal, to Vila Moura. And while I at this point, my missus didn't know I took the fight. She thought I was going to be retired.
Are you scared?
Yeah, I was fucking, I just got more and more pissed on the rest of the honeymoon, to be honest. So I just kept drinking. And when I started drinking through the day, she must have been thinking, fucking hell, is he so happy with this manager? What's he got coming? And we went to Portugal with the kids for a little extra break after the honeymoon. And in Portugal, I said to her, Rach, I'm flying Dave Caldwell out. I said, what the fuck are you on about? And I said, I'm flying Dave out. I'm going to start camp here and fight Usyk. And she went, you said he's the fucking one person who could really hurt you because you just wouldn't stop. You said that he could fucking, he's a brilliant boxer. I said, listen, girl, I'll fuck him. I said, don't worry about it. I'm going to beat him.
I've watched him. He's not that impressive. I can catch him. And she was like, but if you don't, how much punishment are you going to take trying to catch him? Why are you doing it? You don't need to do it. And I said, listen, it's an opportunity to fight for the undisputed championship of the world. All the belts, things that I couldn't, even my dreams didn't allow me to dream this. I said, so I've got to take it. And she's like, you haven't, we don't need the money. Why are you fighting? So we argued for a couple of days. In the end, she went, well, it's your fucking dream. You want to fulfill it. You go and do it. I've done it. I don't regret it. Brilliant fighter. Brilliant fight. Camp went good.
I thought it was a great fight, man. I thought you were about it.
I'm doing well. I'm doing well for six rounds. And then I'm absolutely fucking knackered after seven. I'm fucking out on my feet, gassed. Don't get me wrong. That last bit of weight's tough, but no, see, I didn't have no shame losing to him. So you know where I've lost against the Don Stevens? I didn't want to come out the house for days. I wouldn't. So I stayed in the house like fucking hiding because I was so embarrassed and ashamed. After losing to him, I wasn't. I can take losing to someone who's just better than me. He is better than me. There's always someone bigger and stronger out there. He was better. I put in a great performance. Yeah, I was ahead when I got stopped. Yes, but it was a 12-round fight. It wasn't a six-round fight. So you've just got to tip your hat to him, mate, and give him credit. He's an amazing fighter.
How do you think he'll do in heavyweight?
I think he'll do really well. I think he'll win a version of the world title.
Yeah?
I definitely think he'll win a version of it. Do I think he can beat the real big boys like AJ and Fury? No.
Too small?
I think he's too small.
Yeah.
He's the same height and build as me. Don't get me wrong. He's fucking beefed up at the minute.
Yeah, he could surprise, man. That speed and power was there.
Don't get me wrong. It's mad because he's actually not that strong. He's not that powerful. Everyone will go, well, fucking hell, he chinned you. Yes. Mate, coming out for that eighth round, my nan would have chinned me. I've never been so tired in all my life. But listen, I was tired because he made me tired.
Yeah.
So it all works in the plan. Mm-hmm. He's not going to be able to put the pressure on me. He's not going to put the pressure on the big boys like he did on me to make me tired. Other fighters will just do what they need to do. Yeah. But his footwork's brilliant. He's an amazing fighter, the best I ever fought. Without a doubt, no one even comes close. Yeah.